Let's start today's tutorial. Today we will see some ALPs which is based on branching operations. Okay, so the first problem is like this. This is the address given. So this is the jump instruction. Okay, after the jump you got to go to this particular address location. Presently we are at 0100. So these are all four different problems given out here. We need to write the opcode or the machine code for each of these jump instructions, right? So if you see, the difference out here is not very much from the present location to the target location. It can be written within using a single byte of information, because the displacement is not that very large. So we can use an which is the instruction which we can jump instruction. We have three types, right? Short, near and far. So we can use the short jump out here, right? Because the displacement is less than 127, right? For an short jump, we know that it is plus 127 to minus 128. If the displacement is that much, we can use an short jump, right? Near jump. So, yeah, short jump. Sorry. So this is the I have placed the snapshot of from the code which I had shared with you. This is the codes for the various instructions. So instruction set I had shared with you a PDF, right? So this is the snapshot from that. So if you see here, for the short, direct within short. Okay, the code is given here. So 1111011. Okay, so that stands for E and B, and there is a displacement which is given here, right? For the near jump, it is not written near here. So just keep this thing in your mind when you are writing your exams. You won't find near exclusively written here. Okay, direct within segment stands for near, and for near jump we know that we can give it a higher we can use 2 bytes, and then hence the displacement will be much higher. It will be from plus 255 to minus 256, right? So whereas for an short jump, the displacement is from minus 128 to plus 127. So depending on the total displacement required, we need to select what kind of jump we require, right? In this case, since the displacement is not that much, we are going to use a short. So this also indirect within segment stands for a near jump, and the last two stands for an it stands for a long jump, right? The far jump, sorry. These two stands, because it is intersegment, so the codes are different out here, right? Another thing which we need to keep in mind is, right, for the short jump, now it is the displacement. Again, for an near jump also it is the displacement, whereas when we are doing with the register addressing, we'll see an example that also. So we have to write the actual memory location when we are doing an instruction, or we are writing an instruction, a short instruction with indirect, that is we are going to write an register kind of addressing. In that case, we have to write the actual address, and also for the far jump also it is not the displacement but the actual IP address and the CS segment address that is written here, right? Okay, so coming back to our problem here, so it is so this is the EB, this is the code which we get for the short jump from here, and we have to write the total displacement. Okay, the total displacement is not the difference between this the present address and the address where we have to go. Okay, this is the target, because this particular instruction is also going to take 2 bytes of memory space, because jump is EB, and then we got to write a displacement also. So this is going to take 2 bytes of information. So actually, if you see, the jump has to go from 0102 to 0105. So actually, there is an the displacement is 3, right? So 100 plus 2 plus 03 is 105. So this 3 comes from the difference between 105 and 100 plus 2. So this 3 comes from here. Is it clear to all of you? Gandhi Vaibhav, is it clear?
Yes, sir.
Okay. So, just be careful. You don't subtract these two and write the value here. We need to add another 2 out here. Okay. And why are we adding that 2? Because once this jump instruction is, this also is going to consume 2 space. So the IP counter, when it comes to this instruction, it will automatically move 2 steps ahead because to execute this, right? So from there, the IP has to move to the next location. That is the reason we have to add another 2 to all these instructions and then find the displacement from there. So like this is the next case also, 177 is the target location, present location is 0152, so we need to add plus 2 and find out the difference. 177 minus 154 is 23, so we write that 23 here, right? So this is how these are the instructions which, so the next two examples are also very similar. Okay. There is some examples where we do an jump backwards, right? Backward means this is the current location, and then we need to go back. Can somebody just tell what would be the displacement out here? Maybe in the decimal form also you can tell, that is also okay. The present 4, yeah, it will be minus 4, right, Vaibhav? It has to be minus 4 because presently we are at 47. So after this instruction, it will go to 49, and we need to come back a 4, right? Similarly, for all of this, we need to do plus 2 and then subtract from and we do subtract from here. So we'll all get negative values, right? So now in minus 4, we need to write it in 2's complement. Okay, so we write in 2's complement. So you get it as FC. Okay, now when you take a 2's complement, again be careful about that. This is the number, right? And then you invert all of them and you add one to the least significant bit. Don't add one more in this nibble also. Okay, this entire thing is a single number. Okay, consider this, the entire 8 bits as a single number. I have seen students adding one here also, considering this and this as a, since it is we get confused because of hexadecimal representation. So you write it in the binary form. The entire 8 bits is to be considered as a single data. And then you invert the entire thing and add one only to the least significant bit. Don't add one out here also, right? Then you will get an erroneous answer. So you add one, so you get the 2's complement. So you write that. Okay, again, EB is common here also because that displacement is, it's a small displacement. So it is a short jump out here. So similarly, we can do these problems also. Everywhere, this is the current location, so you need to add plus 2 and then subtract it from the destination which is given here. So whatever you get, you generally you will get it all in the negative numbers, so you have got to take the 2's complement. So these are all the 2's complement of that number. Okay. So this is the third problem out here. Right, we need to write an opcode and a machine language code for the program given here. So this is the program given here. From here, if you see jump again, essentially rest of the codes to add AL BX, increase BX, decrease, you just have to refer to the code which is given to you, the instruction set which has been given to you in the PDF. So you can just convert it into, let us focus on the jump not Z. Okay, from jump, this is the present location 0011. Okay, we need to jump to again, right? So this is the 0011, it will again consume 2 space, so it will become 0013. So essentially we have to jump from 0013 to 000D. So you got to subtract for the displacement 000D minus 0013. We need to do that. So we'll get the displacement in this case, right? And also, since it is jump not Z, so it is not an EB like in the previous case. So we have to refer to the chart out here and then we have to find out what is the code for jump not Z. So if you see jump not Z is 7 and 5, so 75. So this is the code for jump not Z. And then if you subtract 000D 00013 from 000D, which is the target and destination out here for again. So we get an answer of FA. So we put FA here, right? Now this is going to be the actual code which is written. ALP is going to be actually the assembly language is going to be written like this. So if you see what we write jump not Z again and again here, this is actually a compiler directive. So this kind of language is understood by the MASM. Okay, so once you jump not Z and jump again when we write here, okay, so this is the kind of labels. These are extra instructions which the compiler can understand over and above the assembly language. But if you try to compile even in 8086 emulator, so the emulator is again a kind of it runs a MASM in the background, so it understands the MASM directive. So you write an again, it will learn, but it will convert this MASM directive into a pure assembly language. So this is a pure assembly language. So in the assembly language, you need to write a jump and you need to write the target location where it has to go, right? Whereas in the machine language, in the machine code, it is the displacement which is written here. So these are three different things, and you need to understand clearly. This is the MASM directive, this is the machine code, and this is the pure assembly language. Okay, so what is the difference between an assembly language and a MASM code is and this is actually in when we write in MASM or any of the softwares, it can, and over and above the machine language, these are known as the compiler directives. So these compiler directives makes things easier for us to write a program, right, for a human interface, because you don't have to remember the memory locations and all. So this is easy for us to see the program and write. So the compiler, when we write a program into the compiler, it gives us some flexibility to use these labels and all. But if you see the 8086 assembly language, so in there these labels and are all not permitted. So this compiler converts it into a machine language first, and converts it into assembly language. But normally we call this as ALP or assembly line programming, right? So we call it, this is just to give you an insight into a pure, this is not important for you, because we are going to write always an ALP. So in your exam and all, you can surely use these labels and all. Okay, it's not an issue at all. So because we are going to write everything in the compiler only. We are not this in like when I was doing my engineering, there was no Windows at all. We were all working in DOS. Okay, this DOS. So in those days, we didn't have any compilers at all. So this was not there at all. So we used to punch in these codes into the and there was a hexadecimal code available, keypad available. So we used to punch these directly into the 8086 PCB. Right, so there was an LCD display where we could see. So, but right now, so we are all using we are using compilers. So this is one level higher than the assembly language. Okay, so I hope you understand what are the difference between these three. And only thing is, don't write the displacement when you are writing an ALP. The displacement is written only in the machine code, whereas even in the assembly language, the target location is written here. So that we need to be careful with. Okay. Now this is the opcode. Now we got to write a near jump, okay, using, because if you see here jump and then you got to jump to this location. So if you see the difference between these two, that is more than 1 byte, right? So it is, the displacement is more than 1 byte, so we need to use 2 bytes to show how much is the displacement. So and again from jump here we need to go back to the start also. In both these cases, okay, the displacement is more than 2 bytes. Sorry, it's written 2 out here, but it should have been 3. So it is 3 out here. Okay, so 3 and 3. So we need to make a jump which is more than 2 bytes, right? So to compute that, what do we do? This is 300 and this is 0107. So we need to add 2 also to that. So it becomes 010A, and we find the difference, it will become 01F6, right? So the difference out here is this is 0107 plus 3 we need to do, right? Now why it is 3? Because we need to use an a near jump, right? So and that is going to take 3 bytes. So that is the reason from 0107 plus 3 we are doing plus 3, not plus 2 out here like in the previous case. So this has become 010A, and we are subtracting that from 0300, which is the target location. So you get 01F6. Now you need to find the code for the jump instruction. So this is the, because now we need to give the displacement low and displacement high. So this is the code, right? And this stands for E9. So E9, and then first we need to write the lower displacement, that is F6, and then the higher displacement, right? Lower displacement and then the higher displacement, right? Similarly, from here we want to jump from here to back, right? So 0102 is the target location, 0302 is the present location, but you are adding another 3, so this becomes 0305. That 3 is again because this instruction is going to take 3 byte of information, so that is the reason we are adding another 3 to here. So when we subtract it, we get FD FD. So this is the lower displacement and this is the higher displacement, and this is the code for the near jump. Okay, this we get it from this chart out here, right? I hope this is clear. Okay, so let me go to the next problem out here, right? It is, what is the content of the IP register after the jump instruction? You write a jump 0800, right, and 0200H, right? What is the, so now if you see, this is a pure assembly language. Okay, so in the assembly language, when we write like this, it is the target destination, right? It is the target destination. In the assembly language, we write directly the target destination. So this is going to be the CS location, and this is going to be the IP location, right? And what is the code for that? Now code is EA. Right? Why EA? Because it is an far jump. So if I go back here to that chart, okay, direct, inter segment, right? So this is an E and this is A, right? So that is how from this chart we get EA. So this is the code for that. And then first we need to declare the IP. Where we, again mind you, here in this case it is the it is not the displacement. If you see the code out here, right, for a far jump, this is the code which is EA, and then offset low, offset high, okay, that is the IP address, and then segment low and segment high. Okay, it is not the displacement, so you don't have to calculate the displacement in this case. We need to specify the we need to directly specify the IP, right? And whereas but this IP will get result lower displacement and then the higher displacement, again the lower displacement and then the higher displacement, right? So you need to be careful with this lower displacement and higher displacement, because in the midsem also many of you have made this error. Okay, so this is the lower displacement and this is the higher displacement. So once this jump instruction is executed, so you will find the new CS will be 0800 and the new IP will be, right, 0200, right? So this is how this code is written for this jump instruction. So we'll take one more example. This is again indirect addressing, which I told. Okay, in this,
sir, case, could you explain the previous thing, how it become 002 and 0008?
This is the machine language code, right? This is the format for an machine language code, direct inter segment, where this is the code. Okay, code is an E and A, right? And then after that, offset low. Okay, offset low is the difference between offset is the memory addressing offset, right? So this is the offset values, and this is the segment low and segment high. Here in this case, the offset is the IP address, right? 0200, the IP address. So first lower nibble we need to lower byte we need to write. So we are writing 02, and then offset high, which is 02.
Okay, sir.
Right. Similarly, this is the CS, the data in the CS, right? So now the CS needs to be amended. So first we write the, because this is, we follow the Little Indian format, right? So 00, and then we write 08 out here. Is it okay?
Okay, sir.
Okay. So again, only thing is here we don't, because it's a far instruction, we don't have to bother about the displacement and all, the direct values is written here. Okay. Similarly, this is also a register kind of addressing, indirect addressing. Here also it's not the displacement is not calculated. Okay, it is the direct value. Now here the jump, the memory location, the where it has to jump is been specified by BX within square bracket. That means we'll have to look at a memory location where which is indicated again by BX register, right? So BX is 1000 and DS is given as also 1000. So it will become 11000, the address in which BX is pointing, right? So you know this, how to calculate, right? DS into 10 plus BX, right? So 11000, this is the address in which this is pointing out. Now when we write jump instruction, so it is known that we'll have to take 2 bytes, because finally we have to find out the address, right? So the final address which this jump is going to point out is 0002, correct? Because you have to take the address is given by BX, right, which is indicating, which is 11000, but it is an it is actually an a word when we write like this. So the actual address is we have to jump to a location 0002, right? So so the new IP after the jump will be 0200, and the physical address would be after that. Okay, it will be because it is IP, the new physical address will be CS into 10, the value of CS is given here, plus the IP, IP is 0200. So you get, this is the physical address after it is going to execute, after the jump instruction is executed, the IP will be pointing out towards this physical address. Is it clear to all of you? Right. So BX is given by 1000, DS is given. So this is the equation, and because it is finally we have to in the jump instruction we have to find out an address. So this is the location of the new address. So this is the new IP, right? So this is the new IP, and with the use of CS this gets right. This is the last problem which we are going to see. See, this is a data. Data is given by 8. 8 is the total size of the array. So when we say, generally when we write an array, the first element indicates the size of the array. That is the total number of unique values which are there in the array. So 8 stands for, there are 8 values. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. And we need to finally get a data in the AL register, the first positive number in the array. Okay, so the code goes like this. We load the address of this array into the SI register. So you have a load effective address instruction. So SI array. So the into the SI register, we have the address of the array. Okay, the location of the array, it comes into the SI register, and then move CL SI. The contents of this now the contents from that array, the first element is being brought into CL, and since we are going to use a loop which decrements the entire CX registers and checks whether the CX register comes to zero or not, so that is the reason we put a 00 into CH also, and then we increase SI and move AL SI. The first element is brought into the AL register, and then we do and test AL. So test AL, essentially what it does is it does an AND operation, right? So it is doing an 80. It is 1000 and then another 4 zeros, right? So it is going to AND the contents of AL register with 1 and then followed by 7 zeros. So only the MSB gets remains, and whereas the all the other digits becomes 0, because you are doing an AND operation with 0. So only after this operation in the test, okay, the in the AL register, okay, the AL register is not amended, because this is kind of an test, right? So in test it only compares, and only the flag register is affected. So once we do the test operation, if in the AL, if the most significant bit is 1, it will remain 1, and if the most significant bit is 0, the flag, the sign flag will become 0. So after these things, we just have to see the sign flag gets affected. So if it is a positive number, the sign flag will be 0, and if it is a negative number, the sign flag will be 1, because you are doing an AND operation, and only the most significant bit is checked out here, whereas we are masking off the all the other bits. So then you can write in a loop if not 0 instruction out here, right? So till now all the programs which we learned, we had only the loop instruction, and now it is a combination. This checks for two conditions. The first condition it checks is whether after that, if the flag is 0 or not. If it is not 0, or right, if it's not 0 means it is a negative number, loop, it will go back to the loop next. So it will come back here, increase the SI and get the next data, and also it will check for the counter value also. It will, because this instruction will automatically decrement the CX register also, and if CX is not 0, again it will loop. Okay, so the important thing to note here is it will jump back to the next for checking for two conditions. Okay, one, if it is not 0, not 0 comes from the previous instruction which has been given, that is from the test. Okay, and once it is not 0, it will also decrement the counter of its own, like it does for a normal loop instruction, and then it will also check for. So only if both the conditions are meeting, that if the counter is a non-zero value and also it is a negative number, then only it will loop, otherwise it will come to the loop. So whatever it encounters first, whether the counter becomes 0 or it encounters a positive number, it will come out of the loop. So this is how complex loop instruction is written. Okay, is it understood by all of you? Okay. So we'll stop it here. In case you otherwise, if you have any doubts, you can ask me. If there are no doubts, then we'll stop it here. Right? Okay. Thanks a lot.
Excuse me, sir.
Yeah, tell me.
Sir, I have a doubt. Can you once explain how to write the directives like dot code, dot startup, dot end, like this?